I'm going to demonstrate the Canvas Compliance Test Kit, or CTK. I'm currently in the Canvas Experimental Lab, which is one of the Open Digital Lab clusters running on AWS. This is the Rancher user interface. We're managing our clusters in Rancher. You could use any user interface to demonstrate this. So this is the cluster. I've cloned the Compliance Test Kit repository from the Open Digital Architecture GitHub repository. And to run the Compliance Test Kit, you just do an npm start in the Compliance Test Kit folder, and it should spin up components running in the cluster and run a series of tests, and then you can go and look at the test report. So starting the test, and we should see in this cluster an oda.tinform.org group. This is the component which is being deployed. You see it's gone through its various stages of being deployed, and you can also see that component has a set of APIs. There's not a lot to see while the test is running. You see it's going through a number of tests. You will see APIs appear and then disappear as it upgrades a component with additional APIs. It then downgrades a component. When they're ready, we will see the compliance report. You see, it's just added another API, and it will, in a few seconds, get rid of it. So that was testing and upgrading a component to one which has an additional API. Now it's tested downgrading to one which had one fewer APIs. The test takes about 1 minute at the moment. And you can see it's run 15 scenarios and 50 tests. They all passed. And the interesting thing, if I go into this URL, I can actually see the report from that test run. So here is the report, and you can see it's saying 100% of the tests passed. It took 1 minute 27 seconds, and this is showing then the features that were tested. Now, the compliance test kit for the Canvas isn't complete, and in fact the Canvas itself isn't complete, but the features that are there, we do have a set of BDD tests. And so you can see, for example, we're testing that I can create an API resource as part of a component, and I publish the API resource into whichever service mesh or API gateway we're using. I've got a feature where I'm testing that the implementation of the API is ready, so it actually probes the APIs and checks they're ready. As I mentioned, it tests I can upgrade to a component with additional APIs, and I can remove them. And this is actually testing the fact that we can upgrade the versions of the Canvas seamlessly, and I can use operators using previous versions. So these are the tests that we've got so far. And for each one of these, I can go in and drill down into what was the behavior that this is testing. So all these tests are written using this Gherkin language, which is effectively a pseudocode for writing business readable, but also testable behaviors we expect our Canvas to have. And you can see, so for this one, verify an API resource is ready. It's got three scenarios. I'm going to verify it's ready for the core, for the management and security APIs. And each one has a given, when, and then. And it says given an example package. In the implementation, I'll be using Helm chart as our package manager. So given an example package, so this points to a Helm chart. And the package has a product catalog component, and that has one API in its core function. When I install it, then I should see this product catalog management API with an implementation ready status on the service mesh or gateway. And then I test the similar thing for the management APIs, and this time it's testing the metrics API has an implementation ready status. And finally, I test the security APIs, and this at the moment is testing the party role API is ready. So this shows the Canvas CTK. The idea is the actual BDD, the compliance test itself, hasn't got any specifics about what platform you're running on. It's not even specific to being a Kubernetes platform. It doesn't define which service mesh or API gateway or identity platform. It is describing the behavior we expect in a generic language. Behind each one of these blue things, there is a set of TDD, which then turns that into a test, which is testing the particular implementation that you have. So we're using BDD and TDD together, and that's how we're defining the tests.